You're checking out the longest running online radio show on the iPower Evening Show. DeMarco J on Pretty Ricky and Stefan Mason.
American Black History Fact.
Presented by McDonald's.
Deeply rooted within the African American community.
3-6-3-5.
Right here, right now.
On the iPower Evening Show.
Yep, it's time for the American Black History Fact, presented by McDonald's. McDonald's, deeply rooted within the African-American community, 365. Today's little Black History Fact is focused on buck breaking. Now, what is buck breaking? Well, if you're familiar with slavery, we always heard about stories on black women who were kidnapped from Africa against their will, were the ones getting raped by their slave owners during the transatlantic slave trade, heading towards America, and also on American soil. That was not the case. Young black male and female children, along with young adult black males in chains, were also raped by European slave owners on slave ships and on the plantation back in the late 16th century during the 300-year period. The word definition of buck breaking, which was really butt breaking, is the rape and colonization of rebellious African slaves in the south of the United States and also in South America and the Caribbean. In other words, homosexuality was forced upon African male slaves, despite of homosexuality existing long before slavery. Here's more on the definition of the word buck breaking.
You had a ship full of African men, women, and children who at the mercy of the captain and all the sailors on that crew. And those men could have sex with anybody they wanted to. The women, the children, and the men.
You had to see 3 months tied down with these white men. There ain't no women there for the most part. When they start bringing women, they weren't even bringing women. They were bringing girls between the ages of 6 and 15 and raping them all. But they also were raping the men. Same things were happening on the plantation to demasculinize the black man.
Control the slave population is to rape a father in front of his sons, or to take the biggest, baddest black man on the plantation and do something horrible to him to completely humiliate and emasculate him so that people won't respect him anymore. And that still happens to this day.
In the Caribbean, they had seasoning plantations, which were plantations used to break the slaves. And one plantation or one place that had a lot of seasoning plantations was Jamaica. And people have to wonder, what were they doing on these seasoning plantations that was worse than what was happening on the regular plantations? Well, one thing that they were doing on these plantations, especially in Jamaica, they were doing a process called buck breaking, where the white supremacist slave owner or the white supremacist overseer would literally rape black men in front of the whole black population in order to break his spirit, in order to break him down as a man, in order to show dominance against him, in order to show the rest of the black population that this is not your leader. I just made your leader submit to me sexually. And this happened a lot in Jamaica.
This is why homosexuality is so looked down upon in Jamaican culture today.
And it was a way primarily of cutting down those who would rebel. In other words, it was a matter of power and control and domination. And they would call it buck busting, but it was really butt busting.
Slavery continued until 1865 for about two generations, right? So how do you reconcile that? You can no longer bring in Africans, but you still have the business of slavery. So they still needed Africans to do the work down south, especially after the cotton gin was invented. So you had the creation of breeding farms. Two of the largest slave breeding farms in the United States were on the eastern shore of Maryland and right outside of Richmond, Virginia. They literally bred black people like cattle. They would have a strong black man have sex with a healthy black woman. That woman could be his mother, his sister, his aunt, his cousin. It didn't matter because the end product was produce a child that I can sell, bodies that I can sell and ship down to Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina. It was a business.
We had breeding farms in the United States that would put one person from one plantation against another. We even had a system where if you were a breeder, male on one plantation, or a female on another plantation, or even on the same plantation, even if you were mother and son, they would mate you. And so I tell a lot of my patients and a lot of my friends, you gotta stop using the MF word, because that was a description of what actually happened when the paper bag would go over the head to put one breeder against another when they were related.
Buck breaking exists to this day in the prison systems across the United States, with the majority of African American inmates who are incarcerated under the law legally in an all male or female correctional facilities, which is another form of slavery existing under the 13th Amendment of the United States Constitution.
This is how HIV spreads around the prison systems, because homosexuality is secretly being sexually performed in these prison systems.
Right. Which is all built by design to make the black man weak, less masculine, and more feminine when they get out of prison.
Right.
Same thing they did during slavery with this butt breaking and not buck breaking.
Exactly.
That's right.
And now y'all know out there, for some black folks who didn't know back then, the next time you say only black women were being raped. No, that's not true. That's not true. Black men and children were being raped as well, besides black women.
Yep. That's right.
So no black person was safe during slavery.
Not one was safe.
And that is your American Black History Fact, presented by McDonald's, deeply rooted within the African American community. 365 Black.
How you gonna know where I'm at if you ain't been where I've been? Understand where I'm coming from?